Hey YouTube, it's Hannibal Bonaparte, and I'm bringing you an online commentary battle for Napoleon Total War. This is a 2v2 battle sent to me by my good friend Ares of both the YG and AA clan. This is actually an AA alliance versus miscellaneous good players. This is Ares, as I just said, as Prussia. His ally, Prophet of the Archangels clan, AA, as France. Ares' opponent over here, this is Yellow, previously of the AG clan, now of the Virus clan. He is playing as France, and Yellow's ally is Napoleon of the BSA clan, Napoleon, and he is playing as the Ottomans, as you can see. Okay, so let's speed this battle up, as the sides are quite a long way away, and it takes a little bit of time for them to come together. Alright. So this was a battle played relatively recently, and I'm going to talk a little bit about the armies as I leave it in fast forward. This is, of course, Ares' army. He has an interesting army. He has these two units over here. These two units are foot guards on the far right flank. All the rest of Ares' line units are musketeers. So he has 7 musketeers and 2 foot guards. Then he has 6 units of lancer cavalry, 3 on each flank. And his light infantry consists of 3 units of Prussian Fusiliers and 1 Silesian Schützen, and then, of course, he has a general staff. Okay, over here, this is Prophet. Prophet is France, of course. Prophet has a relatively sound army. He has Old Guard and more Old Guard on that flank. So this has got 2 Old Guard over here and a Polish Legion with Lancers over there, including a Dutch Guard Lancer. His middle has, let's see, Swiss Foot, 4 units of Swiss Foot with 4 units of Voltigeurs out in front and a general staff behind. And his right flank has the 3rd Old Guard and another Polish Legion, and that side has 2 units of Lancers as well. Yellow has another very interesting army to match Ares' interesting army. He has out here 4 units of light infantry, Voltigeurs out in front. On his right flank he has, let's see, I think it's a unit of National Guard, two units of Polish Legion, and 1 Old Guard. I'm going to put it back into play mode now. And an Old Guard right there. Then he's got, let's see, 1, 2, 3 units of Chasseur à Cheval over here. So that's his right flank. He's got another National Guard back here. Then he's got on his left flank 2 units of Old Guard, and 2 units of National Guard with another 3 units of Chasseur à Cheval. And his general is the general's staff. So he has a lot of National Guard. And once again, National Guard cannot form a square. The Ottoman player has relatively standard Ottoman build. He's got some Bashi Bazooks up in front of a line of 4 units of Nizam 1 Sedis infantry, with 2 shooter cavalry in behind, a Slaughter Guard. Behind on his right flank of his left flank, he's got 2 units of Semats, each with 5 units, 5 upgrades. Over here on his right flank, he's got 3 units of Sedits, with a Bashi meat shield in front, 2 shooter cav, 1 slaughter guard, 2 more Samets with 5 with 5 chevrons each, and a general's bodyguard. So those are the armies, and it's kind of standstill over here. What actually happens in the broader picture, I'm going to zoom out here for a second, no close-ups at this second right here. What's going to happen is these two, Prophet and Napoleon, are going to engage, and then after that, Ares and Yellow will fully engage as well. Okay, so basically, what's going to happen over here is the fight on Ares' side gets started in 2 places. The first place is on the left over here where my mouse is, and then the fight starts on the right. Okay, on the right, Yellow has 2 Old Guard. On the left, he only has 1 Old Guard. So this left over here, Ares' left flank, is weaker. Or Yellow's right flank, which is on Ares' left, is weaker. And so this engagement over here won't fare so well. The action over here is soon going to begin. As you can see, Ares has his lights out in front of his line over here, Prussian Fusilier and Silesian Schützen, and he's going to use them to very good effect over on this side. Now the important thing at this point in the battle is that Yellow has the superiority over here. He has achieved superiority. He has National Guard, which are actually pretty high quality militia, and two Old Guard. He's also got three Shooter Cav. So he's got four units of line over here, two of which are inferior, though not by too much to the Musketeers, two of which are superior, and by a little ways to the Foot Guards. Okay, the one thing that he doesn't have over here is a light infantry unit, but that light infantry unit won't play too much of a course in the battle if he really pushes up hard. And he has three units of Shooter Cav compared to the three units of Lancers. He has relative superiority over here, okay, but he's not going to push up. Instead, he's going to push up over here. This might seem like a good idea. He has four on three. Unfortunately, his cavalry is kind of not very close to the engagement when that really starts. Okay? Also, these lights over here can easily turn and fire. So he has, he's got inferior power over here. He's at a disadvantage. So this engagement over here gets started. And as you can see, there's only one Old Guard over here. And that Old Guard is now going to have some flanking fire put on it by these two units. He's very slightly adjusting these two units so that he can put some flanking fire in on there. And pretty soon, Ares is going to begin some devastating cavalry work. These three cavalry units, he's going to use them to very, very good effect. Actually, I take it back. He's not the first one to use his cavalry, I don't think. But we'll come to that when we come to that. As you can see, the action over here is still not taking place. Whoa, sorry, camera trouble. And over here on this flank, let's see what's happening. Napoleon. I'm just going to call him Napoleon. He got those semi-janissaries in there. Unfortunately, they're fighting against the Old Guard. And the Old Guard, with the help of some other Old Guard, are taking these guys down. There's a nice hammer and anvil right there because Prophet failed to get the Old Guard into square. And as you can see, these upgraded Semats are actually going to beat that Old Guard in melee. So as you can see the action over here, Prophet is actually losing this. He's going to lose that Old Guard unit right there. And he's going to lose that unit of Polish Legion over there. And then that unit of Dutch Guard Lancers is under heavy duress from the Nizam 1 Seditz and the General. He's going to try and use it to good effect. But anyways, I'm going to stick to this action over here. As you can see, a little bit of it got underway. Over here, Yellow charged in with some Shooter Cav. He targeted both of these units with that. He targeted one and then switched to the next. Fortunately for Ares, he got both of those units into square. Okay? There's the last unit over there. That unit is kind of walking around getting shot by the Prussian Fusiliers and the square at the same time. Unfortunately for Ares, he got a little bit greedy here, wanted the Prussian Fusiliers to shoot as long as they could on the Chasseurs à Cheval, and he doesn't take it back immediately. So that musketeer still gets the fire in, but the Fusilier also gets caught. Here comes Ares' massive cavalry charge on the left flank. As you can see on the right flank, there is not much to speak of over there, except for the light fight. The light fight is going on, and he's winning this light infantry fight. So there the cavalry goes. The cavalry goes in. He formed up square there. Good idea. He missed the square on his Old Guard. This is one of the telling moments of the battle. That Old Guard loses the square. Now it's down to 43 men, it cannot form square anymore, and that Old Guard plays no further part in the battle. So that is a waste of an Old Guard right there. It gets chewed apart by that unit of Lancers. And these Lancers over here are doing very, very well. They're going to charge through the units that cannot form square over here into that unit of Garde Nationale. Over here, Prophet's left a unit over here to kind of wrap up. So that's the action over here. There's lots of cav work over here. Again, Ares is going to use his cav very, very well. He's going to ram into those Voltigers to give him the light infantry advantage. He brought less lights. He's got only three units of Fusiliers and a Silesian Schützen, and once these Voltigers are into range, they'll do very well against the Silesian Schützen. So he wanted to get this advantage over here and save his light infantry. He got in there, he did very well, killed 20 of those guys, and he's going to ram into the rear of the Chasseurs à Cheval, and Yellow doesn't notice this, so that's going to be a very good charge right there, right into the Chasseurs à Cheval, does quite large damage, and Ares sees this stake line, and he is not going to ram into the stake line. He's going to take extra precautions so as to not hit the stakes. Over here, this is the engagement starting over here. As you can see, the Garde Nationale, or the National Guard, that is marched up, and that's going to be the first ones into fire. Unfortunately, his old guard were just slightly out of range, so this is going to give the Musketeers an early advantage in this light infantry fight, or, sorry, this line infantry fight. And now he has to move forward again, which is going to be costly, because now these Musketeers can fire. Okay, now he's going to do the right thing. He's charging in his cavalry. And that was pretty good timing, because this his Ares line already got the shots off. So he's going to charge in that cavalry. Here goes Ares' cavalry. He's going to charge in on the old guard. And this is actually quite devastating over here. Let's see, does he make that square? Yes, he makes that square just in time over there. So he makes the squares all around. And there that lancer goes right into that old guard. That old guard forms square. And so the lancer will have to move its target to the next unit. Over here, the Polish legion are routing over there. Old guard have routed, and all that's left over here is one Polish legion in square, which is down to 80 men and being shot at, and the National Guard down to 58, two Chasseur Cheval units, both of which are depleted. Okay, let's see. Over here, that unit of Lancers has tried to get into both the Old Guard. Unfortunately for Ares, fortunately for Yellow, Yellow got that unit of Old Guard into another square, so Ares is going to have to pull away that Lancer again and go to the next unit. As you can see he's doing, he's going to pull that unit of Lancer away and go after the units that cannot form square. And that Lancer is still green. Over here, this Chasseur Cheval unit over there is going to bite the dust very, very soon. And as you can see, this is something weird. His Ares' Lancers are in melee right now, which they're targeting that old guard, but they're just following the Chasseur Cheval. And that was very good for Ares, because that unit is still in square. So this delay over here is going to allow Yellow to come out of square. And when Yellow does that, the cavalry charge goes in. So squares have been formed here. Ares is going to get out of square first. And his cavalry over there rout. But he's got another cavalry squadron there, which is going to go into the unsquareable units. And over here, Chasseur Cheval are roaming against the lights over here, and the Silesian Schützen. But he formed a square right there, which is going to be pretty effective at stopping that cavalry. Just a quick touch over on Prophet and Napoleon's side. Napoleon has gained the upper hand over here. He's going to he's going to wrap up this flank over there. He caused a breach in the gap. He caused a gap right here. He just routed the last unit over there. So over here you can see Napoleon is going to wrap up that flank right there. So that's what's happening on Napoleon and Prophet's side. Prophet is going to lose this fight over here. At this point, Yellow has lost his attacks. He tried to attack on both flanks and failed on both flanks pretty much. And he really couldn't fail. If he attacked strong, he needed to win. Then again, it was really because of Ares' good squaring. He squared very well, and he countered with his cavalry very well. And there was actually a quote at the very beginning of this game. Napoleon Total War gives you a quote, as I'm sure you know. And that quote actually fits very well with this battle. It's from Napoleon, and Napoleon said, "Ability counts nothing if there is no opportunity." So basically, Yellow is a very talented player. He is very good, and he's a very solid and high-caliber player. But he was just given no opportunity, so his ability counted for nothing in this game. Now Ares is going to push up himself. He's got the advantage over here. His lancer over there is doing great work, absolutely great work over here. It's routed two units of National Guard. It's going to keep disrupting these old guard, keep them from forming square. Okay, at this point, Yellow's going to begin this mass retreat. He's going to pull away as he sees that Napoleon has pretty much won his battle, though not by a gigantic margin, which is important. Napoleon has won his battle. And Prophet is still running around. He's gone in for a semi-melee, which is interesting. So let's see. The Lancer over here is going to continue its work. It's now going to charge into the lights over there while the while his foot guards and musketeer are approaching as quickly as they can.